Yeah, I was doing vocals. Yeah, Calvin's on guitar. No, I don't know what string he uses. Yeah, okay, I'll ask him. Alright, gotta go. Bye.
Bye.
Wow, 23 minutes, new record.
Man, your mum loves to talk.
Yeah, well, she's just got a new phone, and this time she knows how to use it.
Scary.
Yeah, you're telling me. It's driving me mad, always wanting to know what I'm doing.
Well, at least she's interested. I haven't heard from my folks in weeks. They don't seem to know or care what I'm doing here. They think it's some kind of tap dancing school or something. They just don't get it.
Yeah, well, no parents get it.
You know, sometimes I wonder, why do we need parents? I mean, they should just look after us until we're old enough to walk about and say important things like, can I have some money? And then they should just leave us alone.
Don't answer it.
Come on.
What's weird though? Is this only ever your own parents who annoy you? I mean, everyone else's parents are really cool.
Yeah, why is that?
Maybe they've got like this annoying parent gene in their DNA that they pass on to their kids.
Well, my parents have got tons of it.
Maybe one day we'll be able to genetically modify them so they don't annoy us.
That is one gene project I'll be backing all the way.
It's doubtful, but any thoughts from any of you for this afternoon's improvisation session?
Families.
And how to survive them.
Very good.
We could do the story about when my mum let my hamster out of his cage to run around.
Sounds dramatic. What happened?
Disappeared under the floorboards. We never found it again. I cried all week. Why? Couldn't you just bought another one? Well, it was my first hamster and I was only about six. What would you have done?
Dunno.
Let's try it out. See how it feels. Stacey, you play Frankie. I'll play Frankie's mom.
What am I gonna play?
The hamster. Well, you knew him better than any of us.
Well, you're gonna have to cry then.
I can't just cry like that, especially not over a hamster.
Well, try. Lots of plays and films have crying scenes in them. Could be useful if you knew how to do it.
Okay, here it goes. How's that?
Terrible.
Really bad. So I'm guessing I'm gonna have to work on it then.
Yeah.
You're gonna have to.
So I'll be Ollie's mum and you can play the dad.
Who am I gonna be?
You be you.
Okay. I can do that.
Cool.
So what are your parents like, Ollie?
Well, dad's a politician and mum's pretty busy too with her charity work and writing her books.
Wow, you sound quite interesting.
Maybe. When they're not arguing.
Oh no, I can't do arguing. I always agree with the other person just to keep the peace.
I bet you could argue if you wanted to.
No, I couldn't.
Yeah, you could.
Okay, I could.
Did you just agree with us because you didn't want to argue?
Yes.
This is gonna be tricky. Oh no. Mum's just discovered texting. Dear Jay, hope you're well. Do you think she's writing a letter? I'm in so much trouble now.
Tune, man.
Thanks. Couldn't sleep.
Me neither. What's up?
Nothing really.
I just got thinking how it's weird that you can't choose your parents or relatives. It's like someone buying you a pair of shoes without you having a say in it, and then just having to wear them.
And they don't fit at first. They hurt your feet, right?
And then once you scuff them about a bit, you kind of grow into them.
Yeah, well, anyway, my parents split up, so I've been walking around with one shoe since I was about 10. It's a nice big comfortable one, though. I don't mind so much. Play that song again, man.
Okay, man.
I said, do you realise what the time is?
And I said, yes, I do. It's 11:30. That's not late.
I'll tell you whether it's late or not. I said, back at 10. Can you not tell the time?
I just told you the time.
Don't answer me back now. Go to bed.
Look, Charles, it's the first time he's been late.
I don't care. And don't start defending him.
I'm just saying, it's not his fault.
Well, whose fault is it? It's not my fault.
Look, I never see you all term when I'm at school, so how come you can tell me what to do when I'm here?
Look, Ollie, it's all right.
Don't tell him it's all right. Because it's not all right. When you're in my house, you go by my rules.
Look, just shut up, both of you. Just shut up.
Are we still acting?
Kids.
I think he's upset. Was I arguing too much?
Not now, Mum. I just told Ollie to go to bed and he won't. No. What's weird about that?
What's bothering you, Ollie?
Nothing.
Nothing is bothering you, eh?
Nope.
You know, Shakespeare made a lot of jokes about nothing. And what he would say now is that if that nothing is bothering you, then we better find out what that nothing is so we can stop it bothering you. So, what's the nothing?
I was just doing a scene in there, and it just brought back memories.
Yeah, that's the trouble with memories. You remember them. What were they about?
Boarding school.
You didn't like it.
Well, I thought I'd get used to it, but I never really did.
Oh, when they dropped you off at the gates, and you saw their car head off down the drive, you felt sick.
How do you know?
I know. So did you talk to him about it?
Not really. They were always so busy, they just let me get on with things.
What do they think about you coming to Avalon Heights?
Not much. They want me to be a lawyer, like my brother, or a scientist, like my sister.
And you're angry?
Not really. I'm...
angry.
Yeah.
Well, looks like that nothing has turned into something.
Okay, it's easy. Just picture something sad. Look. Then you just sort of picture it getting worse and... it gets even worse, and then you hear the sad music in your head, and Bambi's dead. Dead. Dead.
Wow, that's really good.
What's the matter with her?
She's crying, and she's brilliant.
Well, if she's that upset, she won't mind me taking the tiniest bit.
Oi, hands off, fat guts.
Man, she is good.
So you have a choice. You can either block out all those feelings of anger and frustration, or you can make them useful.
How do you mean?
Performing is all about showing emotions and trying to make them seem real. You can use those feelings to do that. Do you understand?
I guess so.
I know so. Put all of that stuff into your work. Think about the times that made you angry.
Like, when I was in my school play, and neither of them could make it because they were too busy.
Yes, that's annoying me, and I wasn't even there.
And like the time when my dad grounded me for walking around town with my hands in my pockets.
Why?
Because he said, as the son of an MP, I should look respectable. What do you think of that?
What do you think of it?
It's not fair.
That's what I think. What do you want to say to him?
A lot of stuff.
Now's your chance to say it.
So, what's the big crime about putting my hands in my pockets anyway?
I'm your father.
I'm an MP. I don't want people thinking I brought you up badly.
I hardly ever see you, Dad. I pretty much brought myself up.
Ollie, don't be cheeky.
And another thing. Next time I'm doing a performance, you could at least find the time to come and see it. Have you got that?
Yes.
Good. Now, get upstairs and tidy your room.
Ollie, I've just had a call. Your parents are dropping in to see you.
What? How? I mean, why?
Well, I imagine because they're interested in seeing how you're getting on.
Well, can't you tell them not to come? Say there's been an outbreak of plague in the school, and we're all in quarantine.
Tell them yourself. They'll be here tomorrow.
At least they won't be here for our performance this afternoon.
Yeah, that would be really bad.
Okay. So there's this girl called Chiquita, and she lived in the Amazon rainforest. And she had two best friends in all the world, her boyfriend, Julio, and this amazing teak tree in the forest. The tree was her secret friend, as tall as the clouds, as wide as the oceans. And Chiquita loved nothing better than to sit in its big, strong boughs as it whispered its wisdom of 1,000 years into her ears.
Amy, I thought this was meant to be a sad story.
It is. You guys expect pathos on a play. Respect the build. Anyway, so this one day, Julio comes to Chiquita, and he's real pleased with himself because he's just had his first ever job. And he can afford to take Chiquita to the movies and maybe go for a drink after. And so Chiquita asks him, what was the job? And Julio says, working for this big logging company. And all I had to do was chop down this one big teak tree in the forest.
No, he didn't. Not the tree.
Yeah. And so Chiquita never spoke to Julio again. She just sat in the desolate clearing, waiting for the next tree whisper that would never come.
Such a sad story.
Mm-hmm.
What is wrong with me? I can't even cry like you. Or even feel things to order.
Hey, guys. Ollie, your dad is great.
What?
Why didn't you tell us you got such cool parents?
Parents? What are they doing here? They're not supposed to arrive till tomorrow. I can't believe this. Come on, Kush.
Look, I'm really sorry to let you guys down. But I just can't perform it in front of my parents. They'll freak out.
Okay, well, we're just gonna have to think of something else to do without you.
Ollie, can I have a quick word? Just spoken to your parents and they're really interested in seeing what you're doing, but,
Well, if they're watching, I'm not doing it.
But we don't allow parents into student classes.
Really? That's brilliant.
Good, so you'll do your piece then?
Yeah, okay.
Well, we don't want to waste all that effort, do we? Especially after you reworked it.
Yeah, maybe. Suppose I should go and say hello anyway. Thanks, Patrick.
Paddy came down last week.
Good. How is he?
Fine. He's off to Russia to fight the illegal bear trappers.
And he'll win too, I'm sure.
Well. That's great. Actually, we did this play about loggers.
And Viola's work on the genome project is also causing quite a stir.
Yeah, so you said. Look, I really have to go.
Oh, well, how is the tap dancing going?
Mum, it's not tap dancing. It's music, drama, writing, everything.
You know what I mean. It's just fun, isn't it?
Maybe. Or maybe it's my life.
Don't be silly, Oliver.
I won't. Look, I've got to go. I'll see you later.
What is the matter with him?
I've no idea.
Perhaps I should have a word with his teacher.
Yes, come on.
Let's go.
You must be Ollie's parents.
Well, yes.
Yes.
Don't worry, it's not an arrestable offense. It only warrants a caution. Professor Toon.
Ah, very nice to meet you.
Likewise.
Yes, you phoned us. Nice to meet you.
So, have you seen Ollie yet?
Oh, well, he was just with us. He had dancing to do or something.
Uh-huh. He seems all right, though.
Well, you should come have a look, see what he's doing.
Oh, well, they told us that we couldn't go in.
Every performance needs an audience. It would be good to see where he's at right now.
Yes.
You might find it enlightening.
Well, thank you very much.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Ollie's parents stand. Ollie's parents, you've been charged with being too busy with your careers and not giving Ollie the attention he deserves as your son.
Objection, Your Honor.
Overruled. How do you plead?
Not guilty.
Prosecution, your witness.
Can you please tell the court, when was the last time either of you talked to Ollie about anything that mattered to him?
Was it
last year?
Or the year before, maybe.
Would it surprise you to know that you've never really been interested in what he was doing?
Yes, it would, actually.
Well, be surprised, because it's true. And can you explain the reasons for sending Ollie to boarding school?
Well, that was because...
Is it not true that you were both so busy with your own careers that you simply wanted Ollie out of the house? Objection, Your Honor!
Overruled. Answer the question.
No, of course not.
Yes.
But it was only for his own good.
He was happy there, wasn't he?
Don't you know?
Well, he never said he wasn't. You never let me. Don't you see? It's not always easy to say things, especially to you.
Life has never been logical. You can feel like a criminal. Doing things that are natural. Tell me, do you understand? Everybody's got ups and downs, yeah. Your whole world just turns around. You need somebody to trust in you. When tomorrow comes, living each day as if it's the last is what I should do, but I know the day has just passed. Is it all wrong? Is it all right? Is it all black or is it all white? Should I turn left? So many points of view. Look at me and look at you. I'm not trying to disapprove what you're saying to me. Just forgot what I'm fighting for. Who remembered to keep the score? Now I guess I can't afford to buy a secondhand dream. Living each day as if it's the last is what I should do. What I should do, but I know the day has just passed.
Oh, I'm not being funny, but clearly you really are bored.
Order! What's going on? Just get back to your seats. Order! What is going on? Come on, just sit down. Get back to your seats. Order! Order!
Is it all right?
Okay, jury, we reached a decision.
Definitely.
Should I turn right?
Ollie's parents, you've been found guilty as charged. You're sentenced to not being so busy, finding more time for Ollie, and talking to him about the things that are important to him for the rest of your natural lives. Now off you go.
Objection, Your Honor.
Shut up, Calvin.
Very interesting, Ollie.
Quite a revelation.
I didn't know you felt like that.
I didn't mean to upset you. You weren't supposed to be here.
Professor Toon said we could come in. He said we might find it enlightening.
He was certainly right about that.
We better talk. You'd better talk. We better listen.
Absolutely.
Is it all wrong? Is it all right?
Thanks, guys.
Is it all black or is it all white? Should I turn left or should I turn right? Say it's all wrong.
It's been good seeing you again.
You too, Dad.
You were good, Ollie. You'd make a great lawyer. Or whatever you want to be. There's obviously more to this drama business than I thought.
Bye, Mum.
We'll come and see you again.
That'd be great.
Yes, perhaps we could see something a little lighter next time.
Right.
This is a happy moment, Stacey.
Is it really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah. Thanks for doing that.
Sure, why? Wasn't me, Ollie. You did it all. You told them, they listened, and then you told them some more. Reminds me of a funny thing.
What are you doing?
Nothing. Hi, Mum. Yeah, I think you should know, you can't ring me anymore. What, because I haven't got a mobile? Bliss.
Oh.
Hello? Oh, yeah, hang on a minute. Jay, it's your mum.
More iDream next Thursday afternoon at the same time right here on CBBC One for the final episode. Now don't worry if you missed any of today's show, because you can catch it once again this Sunday on CBBC Two as part of Smile, which hits your screens from 7:30. Stay with us because Frankie and Calvin are up next.